Hi everyone, welcome to another interesting session from AgPro Training. Today we will see how to make more human readable dates, times and strings using Humanizer. The agenda of this session will be what is Humanizer, how to install Humanizer to the project, and we'll see the code demo. You might have seen things like view your orders 2 days ago, yesterday, tomorrow, 1 year ago, more human readable representation of the data. So how can we achieve this? We can achieve this using a Humanizer library, and it's a .NET standard class library. I'll show you one live example now. So this is a screenshot taken from the code project. You can see marked in the squares there 6 hours ago. That means this particular topic or an article has been published 6 hours ago. So how it is calculating? It is taking the current time and the previous time when it was published. So the difference here, it is showing 6 hours. The other article is 16 hours, another article 17 hours, yesterday, 2 days ago, 5 days ago, 10 days ago, an year ago, something like that. So this is how we can see the application showing the more readable format. I'll switch to Visual Studio. I have created a console application to start with the Humanizer. So let's start including the library from the NuGet package. You go to the NuGet package manager, on right clicking on the project, you go to browse, and there we type Humanizer. Here you can see several libraries are available with the same name, but the difference here is FR, HR, DE. So these are the localized Humanizer. But if you want only in English, humanizer.core will be sufficient. And you can see that 7.2 million downloads are already happened. At the time of recording, we have a stable version of 2.8.11. So let us install that. When we are installing a humanizer.core, it will also ask several libraries to be included. So let's say, okay, I accept. Installing of NuGet package is finished now. Let's jump into the program.cs. And what Humanizer will do is, it will add several extension methods to the available data types. So one of the data types that we'll discuss right now is a date time. So I'll say console write line. So I'll try to extract a date time from the date time dot UTC now dot add hours. So whatever the current date time is there, to that I will add few hours here. So if I add say 30 hours, then if I want to humanize it, so what I have to do is I'll say humanize. So as you can see, it's showing a red squiggly because we have not yet included the namespace where the humanize method is available. So let's click on show potential fixes using Humanizer. The moment we add that, the red squiggly will go away. Let's run this program now. You can see that now it is showing tomorrow. It is not showing the date time of tomorrow. Instead, it's saying the tomorrow, which is a more human readable word. I have added few more lines here with the different hours and days are added to this. Let's see how the output will come. You can see for minus 30, it is showing yesterday. For just 2 hours of difference, which is negative, it is showing 2 hours ago. And if I say positive 30, it is showing tomorrow. If I say 2, it is showing 2 hours from now. It's a future hours. And if I add say 564 and it's a days, in terms of days, it's showing 1 year from now. If I say negative number, that means it is past, showing 1 year ago. So more human readable dates it has converted. So in some of the blocks, you might have seen a block title and block text, and it will show more and three dots. Okay. So basically the description or summary, it will truncate and it will show the three dots, so that if you click on it, it will show you the entire text. Long text to truncate is a string. To that string, truncate method is an extension method. It got added because we added a library Humanizer, and I'm saying show only 10 characters. So when I run this, You can see that it's showing only 10 characters. If you want to add 3 dots after the text, you can add a second parameter like 3 dots. So if you see the outcome now, it will look like long space TE after that 3 dots. Instead of 3 dots, you can add any character over there. Now let's see how to convert a numerical value into words. For example, we'll say console write line. 1 is a digit or a number. 1 is a number. So when I say dot, you will get a method to words. This is the extension method, came because of the humanizer. I'll run this now. You can see we have given 1, that is numerical value 1. It has printed in a word format. Let's give a bigger numbers here. You can see here 10, 1, 10, 1 billionth for the bigger number what we have given. It has typed everything in a word. So if you want in a ordinal words, I'll copy this in an ordinal way, like a first, second, 20th, 100th. So you can do that also. Instead of words, you can give a to ordinal. So I'll change everything to the same. You can see now, instead of 1, it has come first. Instead of 10, it has come 10th. Instead of whatever the bigger number we have given at the end, it has come 8. Here it is coming as 8th. We can also use this to pluralize and singularize. So let me type something like this. So I will have a string like man, and this string I want to pluralize. So pluralize method I'll use. It's an extension method for the string. If I run this, you can see man become men because of the pluralize method. So like man, I have given few more words like wife to pluralize, men to singularize, vehicles to singularize. Man become men, wife become wives, men become man because of the singularize, vehicles become vehicle. So we can pluralize the data or singularize like that. For a string, we can transform to cases like lowercase, to sentence case, to title case, and to uppercase. Here I have a string which says sentence casing. Same 10 sentences I put everywhere, but I am changing it to lowercase, sentence case, title case, and uppercase. So the output you can see, it has been transformed to lowercase, to sentence case, to the title case. The difference between sentence case and title case is, title case, every word will be uppercase. Sentence case, the first word, first character will be uppercase. So uppercase means everything is in the uppercase. So far we have seen humanize. How about reversing it, dehumanize? For example, this is a more readable format. Pascal case input string is turned into sentence. Same thing. So here, how do we convert something like which we, it will be difficult for us to read, but it will be easier for computers. So it's called as dehumanize. And also kebabarize. That means hyphen will come between all these words instead of a space. So let's see the output. Here you can see what we have given here, dehumanize. It has removed all the space in between and it has made one single word. Same thing, kebabarize. So it is Pascal hyphen case. Everything wherever the space was there, it has removed that. Instead, it has put a hyphen in between. So this is a kind of an introduction to humanize. You can go to the humanizer GitHub page. You will get much more methods to deal with this type of data. Thank you for watching the video. Subscribe to our channel. Like us in the Facebook, follow us on Twitter, join our group in LinkedIn. If you like the video, share this video in your friend circle. Thank you.